Good morning, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Mr. Ong Math Lesson. In today's video, we are going to work out the 2020 NCA MCAT, also known as the Mathematics Common Assessment Test, Level 1, and hopefully we will go through. This video is broken down into three different parts. The first part is on question 1, the second part on question 2, and the third part will be on question 3. So we shall look at question 1 today, and there will be 1 achieved, 2 merit, and 2 excellence questions in question 1. So let's tackle the question now. So the first question is, find the values of 3x squared plus 8 plus 2y squared plus x squared minus 2 when x equal to 2 and y equal to minus 3. So in other words, we are going to do substitution. Instead of x, we are going to replace it 2. And instead of y, we're going to replace it with minus 3. So the step we're going to do is that we are going to substitute. So to substitute them, we are going to put 3 bracket. Instead of x squared, we're going to put 2 squared plus 8 plus 2. Instead of y squared, we're going to replace with minus 3 squared plus x squared replaced by 2 squared, and then you minus 2. So far, so good? Great. Now we are going to use some mental calculation. So 3, 2 squared is 4, plus 8, plus 2, minus 3 squared is going to be 9, and then 2 squared is going to be 4, minus 2. Following? Good. Now we are going to simplify. 3 times 4 is going to be 12 plus 8. 2 times 9 is going to be 18. 4 will remain and then minus 2. Okay, now we're going to simplify them. 12 plus 8 is going to be 20. 18 plus 4 is 22. And then you're going to minus 2. So 20 plus 22 is 42 minus 2. And the answer is 40. And that is an achieve for the first question. Not too bad, right? Great. Now we are going to do the second question. The second question is solving inequalities. So solving inequalities is just the same as though we are doing an equal sign, if you have not learned that. So the first thing we're going to do, we are going to expand. So I'm going to do a quick method. I'm not going to show you how to expand. Watch my other video if you do not know how to expand. So 3 times 2 is going to be 6. 3 minus x is minus 3x. Minus 2 times 3x is minus 6x. Minus 2 times plus 1 is minus 2. That is on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, when you expand, 14 times 1 is going to be 14 minus 14x, because 14 times negative x is going to be 14x, negative 14x. Okay, now we're going to simplify like terms. Okay, to simplify like terms, we are going to take 6 minus 2 is going to be 4. Minus 3x minus 6x is going to be minus 9x. And the symbol still remains the same. And it's going to be 14 minus 14x. So far, so good. Great. Now, what are you going to do? We are going to minus 4 on both sides. Minus 4 on the left, minus 4 on the right. So these will cancel out. So you're left with minus 9x is greater than 14 minus 14x. Okay. Now we're going to get rid of this 14x. So you're going to add 14x on both sides. So this will cancel out. Minus 14x plus 14x will cancel out. So what you left on the left-hand side, 14x minus 9x will give you 5x. It's greater than 14. Sorry, this is 10. 14 minus 4 is 10. So it's 10. And the last step, you're going to divide by 5. So x is greater by, divide by 5. Divide by 5. Is x is going to be greater than 2. And that will give you a merit. Okay, let's proceed. Now we go to the third question, which is an excellence question. This is algebraic fraction. So the question is 3 over x plus 2 plus 5 over x minus 4 equals to 2. So what I'm going to do now, I am going to make a common denominator. So the common denominator is going to be x plus 2, x minus 4. Then to get that, you divide this by that, you are left with x minus 4. So 3 bracket x minus 4, because you multiply x minus 4 on both the numerator and denominator, you get that. And then on the second expression is going to be 5 bracket x plus 2, because you multiply both the numerator and denominator by x plus 2, and you will get that expression. And on the right hand side, it's going to be 2, you multiply by both x plus 2, x minus 4, over x plus 2, x minus 4, because you multiply the 2 with the denominator. Okay, now what you're going to do, since they are all the same denominator, you can say that 3 bracket x minus 4 plus 5 bracket x plus 2 is equal to 2x plus 2 x minus 4. Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to expand. It's going to be 3x minus 12 plus 5x plus 10. That is going to be 2x plus 4. You expand this part first. It's going to be 2 bracket x squared minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. Okay, following? Okay, simplify. It's going to be like them. 8x minus 12 plus 10 is going to be minus 2. And on this side, it's going to be 2 bracket x squared minus 4x plus 2x is going to be minus 2x minus 8. So far, so good? Okay, now what we're going to do, we are going to expand on the right-hand side. 8x minus 2 is equal to 2x squared minus 4x minus 16. So you want to make it equal to 0, so you minus 8x plus 2 minus 8x plus 2 on both sides. So on the left, 0 equals to 2x squared minus 10x minus 14. Sorry, this is minus 12x. Minus 4x minus 8x is minus 14. So your equation is going to be 2x squared minus 12x minus 14 equal to 0. Simplify them, take out the 2 as the factorize it, x squared minus 6x minus 7 equals to 0. Okay, now we're going to factorize that. So x and x, the common factor is going to be minus 7 and plus 1. Simplify them, it's minus 7x plus x. Add them up, it's going to be minus 6x. And what you got there? So your common factor is going to be 2 bracket x minus 7 x plus 1 equal to 0. There are many ways to factorize that, but I'm doing the trial and error method. So now your answer is going to be x minus 7 equal to 0, or x plus 1 equal to 0. So x equal to 7 or negative 1, and that is an excellent. Okay, try to do it again, and you should be able to get it if you practice them hard. Okay, good. Next question is going to be a word problem. So they say that find the total area of all the three shapes. So you're going to add the area of a triangle, area of rectangle, and area of the rectangle, second rectangle. So area of the first triangle is a half times x times 2x. Simplify them, you get x squared. Area of this rectangle, x times y, is going to be xy. And the area of this rectangle is going to be, this is actually z. So xz. X times z is going to be xz. So the total area is going to be x squared plus xy plus yz. Okay? Now you're going to factorize. X is the common factor. Take out x. So you're left with x plus y plus z. Now they told you that x is 6, so we replace 6, and then x plus y plus z is 12. So add them up together, 6 times 12, multiply them, it's going to be 72 centimeter squared, and that is an easy merit. Great.
Good.
We're doing the last question. This is a bit closer to level 2, but if you can do this, you'll be fine. Okay? So this is how we go. Okay? So what you do, you're going to make all these numbers the same place. So 8 power x is the same as 2 cubed, and then the x there, because 2 cubed is 8, and then multiply 4 is going to be 2 squared, so it's going to be x 2 squared, x squared minus 6, and that is equals to 4. So far so good? Great. Now, what we're going to do, 2 squared, 4 is 2 squared. So if the base is the same, you can add the power. So 3x, because you multiply, you add 2x squared minus 6, that is equal to 2. So you take all the top part, because these are multiplication. When you have am times an, you take am plus n. Okay? So that is how you do. Am plus an is equal to am plus n. Okay? So from there, we are going to simplify algebraically. 3x plus 2x squared minus 12 equals to 2. Now you're going to rearrange 2x squared plus 3x minus 12, and then you minus 2 on both sides, minus 2 equals to 0. Simplify them, 2x squared plus 3x minus 14 equals to 0. Now you need to factorize them. So 2x and x, you factorize them. Do your method. I'm doing the method that I am familiar with, plus 7. This is going to be minus 2, because 7 times minus 2 is going to be minus 14. So x times 7x is 7x. 2x times minus 2 is going to be minus 4x. And when you add them up, it's going to be plus 3x. And what you get in the middle. So the answer is going to be 2x plus 7. X minus 2 equal to 0. Solve it. 2x plus 7 equal to 0. Or x minus 2 equal to 0. So 2x equal to minus 7. X equal to minus 7 over 2. Or add 2 on both sides. X equal to 2. So that is the two answers. And that is an excellent. So hopefully, go through question 1 again. And we'll go through question 2 in the future. Have a good day and enjoy yourself.